Okay. Well, hi everybody. Welcome back. Welcome for our second session. Yeah, and we're in for a treat. We have Eric and Zach with us here in our studio here in Mexico. So they're going to be playing together some beautiful music. And so I'm going to pass it over to them right now.
Okay. hi everybody.
Hi everyone.
Well, it's good to be back in the musician chair, this time with a new musical partner.
It's good to be here for the first time.
Yeah. Yeah, some of you might remember 2 months ago, I think it was, that Ricky, my friend Ricky Como, and I played together. And it was similar in that we hadn't played, Ricky and I, together in a long time. And so we were kind of just, we were really just winging it and asking, you know, Spirit to just tell us what to play moment by moment. But it was very much a spontaneous experience of not having a clue. And yeah, Zach and I have never played together, really. I think maybe we've done some meditational music before together, but in terms of playing like a full concert, this will be a first.
Yeah. Yeah, it seems like a beautiful opportunity to just kind of pray like moment by moment what it's gonna be for us. And I think it's like this desire for both of us to like pray into what it is moment to moment kind of showed up actually as well in our process as we got ready for this concert together, where we got together like yesterday evening to run through some songs and come up with a plan. Yeah, I think we both kind of left that session feeling like not very connected to each other and just kind of like, how are we gonna put this together? Like, what's kind of the missing piece here? What's going on? Because I'm not really feeling connected and you're not really feeling connected. And then we kind of came together this afternoon. And I know in my heart, it was like kind of an insight, like, oh, I still think it needs to sound good. Like, I still think it needs to be a certain way, like the chords need to line up. It needs to sound good. And if I'm like solely focused on that, then there's actually no space in my mind for like feeling connected with Eric, which I feel like is kind of the more important thing. Like if I'm just focused on getting it right, then the whole point of why we do what we do in the first place is just completely overlooked. So, okay, well, no wonder we're not feeling good. And, just by sharing that, actually, I think there was kind of an opening to kind of explore some of the things that were going on during that first evening, some of the thoughts we had about each other as well, which is like, this is really the only reason we would collaborate is to kind of be transparent with each other and share the thoughts and go through the healing. If it's just about like playing music, even playing music together as if we're like two people doing the same thing together in form, it's like, that's death right there. I don't want to do that.
Yeah, we're definitely not here to give you a concert, but we're really here to let the spirit give us an experience of healing for ourselves, which we know is what all of you are here for. And it's, yeah, it always feels so deep when we're brought together in this community to collaborate for healing, because both Zach and I we've been musicians for, I don't know how long you've been. I mean, like 25 years. I think I started learning guitar when I was a teenager, but it was really for a lot of egoic reasons. I mean, I originally just wanted to get more girlfriends. And that was my primary goal for learning how to play guitar and sing. And then, you know, as I got into the course, and I, especially when I came into this community, I could feel that the spirit wanted to use my music for purely for healing, and not, it was like no more trying to look good, no more trying to be a good musician. The only point of music now is for your own healing. And then in that, you know, the spirit will still bring a blessing, like the music will come through in a way that can bless everybody. But yeah, for Zach and I coming together today and yesterday too, it felt like there was just a lot of like things that we needed to expose, like judgments about each other. I had this judgment that Zach is very like linear with music, and you know, he has a lot of training that I don't have. I've always just been more kind of, I don't know, like a campfire guitarist. And I think you actually taught music or in a school for quite a while.
Yeah, middle school choir teacher.
So it's felt like coming together has just been for us to look at these self-concepts and expose them and release them and just pray that the spirit will play through us in a way that brings healing to our mind.
Yeah. Yeah. I know for myself, I can see that music, when I joined this community, I feel like music was one way I could get love from people, basically. It seemed like that was what it was for. And actually, if I'm honest, I feel like it's almost, it actually is the only way I felt like I could get love from people. Like I came into the community with this super refined skill, but that was it. You know, when I joined the community, I didn't know the difference between a Phillips head screwdriver and a flathead screwdriver. I didn't know how to cook anything. Like some of these basic skills that people have, I just kind of missed out on somehow. So, but I can play a really good Beethoven sonata. So please, please love me for that is kind of how it came through. And so it almost feels like with some of these early lessons, like it became really clear early on, like, okay, but what's kind of the deeper wound? Like, how can I actually build a sense of self-worth? I mean, you know, sourced by spirit, that lasts, that's not so dependent on, oh, but I'm really good at this skill. And that's where like really tuning into the fact that I do have a choice actually in every moment. Like, do I want to be so concerned with how it's going to sound or how I'm coming across? Or do I just want to feel connected? Because actually in the transparency of being 100% genuine, like right now, all these considerations don't really seem to be so important, like whether I play it right or not play it right, what skills I have, what skills I don't have. Erik kind of in our joining and kind of unearthing some of these thoughts, I think Eric kind of told it like it is a little bit. I don't know if you wanted to.
You'll have to remind me, what did I say?
I think you were just kind of sharing like, yeah, I felt like when I met this person, I had these thoughts like, wow, he's like super weird and awkward, and I don't want to spend time with him. Like, I don't know how to connect to him. But the fascinating thing is, like, for a certain period of time when you were sort of sharing all these things, and it wasn't just that, which is kind of the beautiful thing. It was like, it felt like one after another, like, I've actually had all these things that I've been keeping in. And, you know, it's like, I felt like you took a risk by sharing all these things, because the past learning, I mean, I know for myself, whenever I got these reflections in the past, it's like an immediate like defense, like, oh gosh, I don't want to hear that. The guilt's too much. Like, I don't want to actually consider the value in what's being shown to me. But the fascinating thing is, when confronted with that and just like kind of letting it in, like, oh wow, there's a certain amount of acceptance there. Like, huh, that's what Eric thinks about me. Well, that's interesting. And there's like a relief there, because I don't have to wonder if people are like holding back because of me being defensive. It's like, oh wow, like I can trust that you're going to share what you're going to share. And in that, I don't know, something happens. It's like, I don't have to take it so personally either. Because it's just what is. So I think in the moment, the only thing I could do is laugh. It was just like, oh,
yeah,
he thinks I'm awkward.
I know, this is only in the hiddenness of these private thoughts that come up that they seem to have power, that we can all telepathically feel like there's something in between, and it seems personal, like my thought about you, but it's once it's exposed, and it's then there's like a space to see, oh, this is just a thought, like an ego thought. And then I don't know, it was like we weren't feeling connected at a certain point today, but then yeah, just started practicing no private thoughts and no people pleasing. and then it felt really good, like, wow, we're just back in the love, back in the experience of like just trusting that we've been guided to this moment together to share and to collaborate and to be used, be truly used with a capital U, like for my mind's healing, for the healing of my mind. And I'm just so grateful for all that, the healing that these kinds of collaborations seem to allow. It's deep.
Yeah, so it's like small wonder why we weren't feeling connected last night, when there's this much underneath it that needs to come up. Then, like, that's the only option, actually. You can try and like rearrange the form, or try and fix certain things, like, oh, maybe I would feel better about working with you if you moved your mic stand a little bit, or played it a little bit better. But after kind of exposing the thoughts and whatnot, like, the love is right there. It's always right there. And the fascinating thing to me is, like, as soon as that happens and we're feeling connected, then the music actually sounds good. It's like, that's all that's needed. So that's why I think for us, you know, this concert that I think we're going to get to pretty soon.
We might eventually play a song.
Yeah, the concert is really about that, because it's like everything is included in that. I feel like there can't be some aspects that we have to give up when we put the connection first. It's like, oh, everything just kind of falls into place, because that's the most important thing, like feeling connected. Mm. Here, by necessity, means I feel connected to spirit. So I'm just kind of looking forward to practicing that.
Yeah, first things first. It's always about the relationship. Well, do you want to start with one? We've got a couple hours here. Some of you are watching on YouTube and Facebook, and for those of you on YouTube or Facebook, we're only going to be sharing a short period of this, because we're going to be playing some copyrighted songs that YouTube will shut us down for. So we might play 3 or 4 songs, and then we hope you'll join us in the Zoom room here with everybody. We'll probably have a link there for you to join, to sign up for the full retreat. But which song were you feeling to start with?
I think it's good with Just Relax. Mm-hmm. This is one of my favorites of yours, actually. Mm-hmm. And it's a good way, I think, a good way to start, because it's like when I get filled up with like stress and expectations and stuff, I'm not even aware that I have a choice to choose the connection in the moment. So
right, that's when that's when relaxation is a good piece of guidance.
Like, do not fight yourself.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, let's go for it.
Here we go. Just relax. Just relax and go slow. There's no need to hurry, for there are no monsters chasing you. Just be still and let go. There's no need to worry, and there's nothing that you really need to do. And take time to look inside, for I can promise you there's nothing about yourself you need to hide. Off the mask and let the light shine on your innocent face. You've never done anything wrong. There's nothing scary to protect you from. Your nightmares are over, you don't need to run. Just open your eyes and see there's nothing to fear. All of your nightmares have long disappeared. Time ago that you dreamed you left home and wandered outside in the cold.
your heart and it's still in your soul. Just take off your heavy armor and let it go. And listen to me while I sing you this song. Your friends are all
I always love how I can feel sometimes when I'm really just in the flow, and afterwards it'll feel like my head is like kind of buzzing, like this, like almost like spirit's like buzzing my head, expanding it, or yeah, it feels good. That was a beautiful experience. Singing that with you. Yeah, that was one we hadn't rehearsed too. That was our first time doing that one together.
Go figure.
Yeah, go figure. Yeah, there's something so precious when I've always loved collaborating with people musically, both because it brings up a lot of healing, but then when there's that feeling of being connected, it just feels like, I don't know, like it feels like some kind of a mental dance, like being so like tuned in to hearing like the rhythm that you're going at, and then also hearing like the spirit moving through me, and how it just, I don't know, it merges and yeah. Yeah, I remember too that when it was about 10 years ago, I was guided to get married to this woman, Armel, And she didn't have any musical training at all, but she was guided. She started hearing spirits singing her these songs, and she was guided to write songs, and then she'd bring them to me. And I just remember it brought up so much so much healing for both of us in a different dynamic than you and I have. But with her, it was like she had no training. She could barely sing on key. And so I just had to stay so, I don't know, like it really forced both of us, but I know for myself, to just go really deep into letting go of all the judgments about how it sounded, and trying to, you know, get her to sing better, or like I had to really let go of all those preferences, but it felt so worth it, because then we would sing together. And this, the one thing that she had that was really was beautiful for me was a lot of passion. And when she sang, and the passion would just come through, it was like, yeah, we both would just get into that really strong, passionate feeling to sing together. And then, yeah, that just made everything worth it. Like the experience of the fruits of healing and forgiveness. And yeah, it was a lot of forgiveness.
Yeah, I think I was mentioning a little earlier that it's interesting, like one of the things you shared about me earlier was the kind of linear like way of playing music that doesn't really allow too much room for feeling it and whatnot. But you know, when that pattern carries on for months or years, then I guess you get put into a situation where you've got a 2-hour session with about a day of rehearsal. So I, you know, it's like at this point, I don't feel like it's possible to plan it all out ahead of time. It's it's more like you gotta feel it. And I really liked what you shared also about kind of like the Holy Spirit activation, like the buzzing, because it's like, yeah, I mean, I feel like that's kind of also when I can tell that I'm activated in a certain sense. It's kind of like I'm even just like sitting still, but there's just like so much energy in me. It feels like I'm on the edge of something, but I have absolutely no idea what I'm on the edge of. It's just this constant like
yeah,
feeling.
Yeah.
Which I guess is how the Holy Spirit uses it.
I know. I love that. I can know that I'm in the tractor beam when I'm like on the edge of kind of buzzing, and sometimes there's a little bit of fear too, but it feels so alive. That's what I love about this. I love about this whole community, and what David represents too is the spontaneity. And like Zach and I just really didn't know we were going to be playing together until I think 2 maybe 3 days ago, but it was like, oh, that feels expansive. This feels new. This feels fresh. This is not going to be something we can perfect in 3 days. So yeah, it's almost like that we keep being guided to situations outside of the comfort zone. That was what Linda shared earlier. Linda at our La Casa de Milagro, she just arrived yesterday and said, when she shared this morning at the end, she said, I am really out of my comfort zone here. And that's so beautiful. I feel like that's when we're most happy, when we're most alive, is when we're not in our comfort zone. We're just right on the edge or a little bit out of it, outside of it, expanding our going beyond our limitations.
Because in that moment, it's like the spirit can actually fill in the how. It's like only scary or a little bit fearful, I guess, when it's like you feel something, oh wow, this would be expansive, but how are we actually going to follow through on it? But the reason I guess it's expansive is because you actually don't know based on anything you could think of or understand from your past learning. And then that's actually how expansion happens in a practical sense, is it's like, okay, the spirit fills in the how, and now, like, that's actually, I guess, the, like, how development of trust practically works. Like, you can read about the six stages over and over again, but without just kind of jumping off a little bit and right. saying, I feel this, and I don't know how I'm going to get from A to B.
Yeah.
And then
it forces us to, like, pray and ask and rely, like little children, he says, like relying on like an elder parent or an elder brother, like we have to trust in something greater than our own intellectual mind and past learning and ego. And yeah, that's where the beauty, that's where the miracle happens.
A good segue to Fall on Me.
Okay, well, that's
We've
a cover
only done one of your songs.
I think we need to, right? I guess if we do that, then YouTube, we might have to shut it down a little early, because unless we just wing, see if our studio team would allow that. Maybe
I don't know. we're getting.
We don't want to anger YouTube by playing cover songs. So
yeah,
maybe one more of mine before we go to. Something we could get busted for. Yeah. Mm. Well, I'm open. Any that come to you? Silent Song was one possibility that popped in my mind.
Yeah, let's do that. Mm.
Okay. This one's called The Silent Song. Here we go. Can you hear song playing silently everywhere? It's hard to hear if you're listening only with your ears. Can you see the light shining endlessly through your mind? It's hard to find if you're looking only with your eyes. Can you smile, lightens up the world for a while? Will come naturally when you're inspired by the love inside. Can you see we're imprisoned by our beliefs, and we are free anytime we choose to be? If you take my hand, we'll rise together from this foreign. Never need to think nor plan. We must only decide. We'll be happy once we've made up
mind. Walking faster only slows you down. Just be patient, keep your feet on the ground. Can you feel the love? It's all around to help you rise above all the pain. It's all right to just let go and simply fall in love. Can you hear the song playing silently everywhere? Right here, singing softly, that there's nothing to
Hey, maybe we'll do one more for YouTube, and then hopefully those watching on YouTube will then join us.
I kind of feeling heaven is perfect.
Okay,
yeah. Sing some heaven is perfect.
Sounds good. Well, thank you all for being with us and for just. Just holding the space. I always love performing. I don't really like that word, but whatever. Extending.
What we're doing.
In these online retreats, because I can feel like everyone who's here is really here, like just totally listening with a full open heart for the true purpose. And yeah, it just feels so good. Sometimes can seem like being in the audience, you're not really a part of this, but yeah, I can tell you as a musician, I feel like I can feel the audience so strongly every time I play, and it really is a collaboration that I always feel very strongly. Yeah. So, any thoughts before we do Heaven is Perfect?
I don't think so.
Here we go. Another one we've never played together. It's very exciting.
Heaven is perfect right now. Heaven is perfect, and heaven is here right now. Everything else that I seem to see doesn't really matter, 'cause it's got no reality. All I really want is to remember heaven within. Spirit is perfect, my spirit is perfect right now. Spirit is perfect, what I am now. Everything else that I seem to be doesn't really matter, 'cause it's not my reality. All I really want is to remember the spirit I am. And that I'll have to fall from grace ever again. I can just relax and listen to your voice, beloved friend. I hear you calling me back to the home. Heaven is perfect. Heaven is perfect right now. Heaven is perfect, and heaven is here right now. Everything else that I seem to see doesn't really matter, 'cause it's not my reality. All I really want is to remember this heaven within. This heaven is perfect. Heaven is perfect right now. Heaven is perfect. Heaven is here right now. Spirit is perfect, my spirit is perfect right now. Spirit is perfect, and spirit is what I am now. Heaven is perfect, and heaven is here right now.
Lovely. Okay, well, if you're watching on YouTube, we're gonna shut down the live stream in a moment, but we'll continue on for those here in the Zoom room, possibly with some cover songs. So yeah, thank you.
Thank you all.
That song you mentioned, yeah, Fall on Me. I don't know if you're still feeling it, but yeah, that's a really, I just heard that for the first time like 2 days ago when you told me you were feeling to maybe sing it. And yeah, I don't know, I watched a YouTube video, I guess it was from a Broadway play called Tick Tick Boom.
Yeah,
is that what it was called? Yeah.
You got it.
By the same producer of Rent, I think he said. But yeah, I really liked the lyrics. I have to pull it up on my oh no, I'm thinking of Louder Than Words, and you said Fall on Me, which is a different song. I'm mixing the two up.
You can do.
Yeah, you're like, okay, I'm
falling. It's time for both.
Well, either one, I'm ready for whatever.
Yeah, we can do Louder Than Words.
Okay.
Yeah.
It seemed like it's about not like giving up compromise. That was kind of the theme that struck me when I first heard it.
Yeah, I actually think it dovetails real nicely with some of what David was sharing about this morning around kind of the importance of willingness. Mm. And really, like, that's all you need. But I think this song kind of goes into kind of exploring almost why we're not willing, and just kind of slowly bringing you to a choice point like that line in the course, your tolerance for pain is not without limit. Like, you can resist and drag your heels kicking and screaming, but at some point, you're just gonna say, like, wow, this really isn't worth it. Like, and that's where it really becomes clear, like almost being forced into a place of like, I'd rather be wrong at this point. And that's where it gets real clear, like, oh, I actually did have a choice. I have a choice now, and I always had a choice. Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer. Actions speak louder than words. And I think as well, that's when that choice point is when it starts to get lifted off the kind of intellectual, like, oh yeah, I know I have a choice. I can just choose again and it's fine. But I don't know, I'm reminded of a parable that I've heard David share a number of times where it's like, he'll go around and see the same course groups every year, and they're still saying the same thing. Like, oh,
I know.
I still have the same. Yeah, I know it's about forgiveness. I still have the same issues with my family or whatever it is. But all I have to do is change my mind, and it'll all be solved.
Right,
well,
right.
Yeah, and you know, there needs to be a willingness.
Yeah, and to follow guidance, which is like, I remember when I first met David and he was emphasizing guidance so much, I had a lot of resistance to that. I remember even at my first devotional stay, Jason, another member of our community, was leading it. And I said to him, where does it talk about guidance in the course? Because I was like, well, it's all about, I know it's about forgiveness, but in terms of the idea of being specifically guided, that was even one of the themes that will be, that David read earlier, following the Holy Spirit with precision. I remember I didn't resonate with that idea at all. I mean, looking back, I just was probably just too frightened of it to even have an open mind. And I said to Jason, where does it talk about guidance in the course? And he said, well, a lot of places. How about right here? And he pointed out that line that says, you will be told very specifically what to do. And I was like, oh. Okay. But yeah, this song feels like it's kind of like where the rubber hits the road. Like, it's actions speak louder than words. That's the name of the song, louder than words. Can't just talk the talk. You got to actually let yourself be guided to really feel it.
Yeah. All right.
Yeah. Why do we play with fire? Run our finger through the flame. Why do we leave our hand on the stove? Although we know we're in for some pain, oh, why do we refuse to hang the light when the streets are dangerous? Why does it take an accident before the truth gets through to us? Cages or wings, which do you prefer? Ask the birds. Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer. Actions speak louder than try to be our best when we can just get by and still gain. Why do we nod our heads, although we know the boss is wrong as rain? trail when the well-worn path seems safe and so inviting. How, as we travel, can we see the dismay and keep from fighting? Cages or wains, which do you prefer? Ask the birds. Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer. Actions speak louder than words. What does it take to wake up a generation? How can you make someone take off and fly? Up the nation, we'll eat the dust of the world, wondering why do we stay with lovers who we know down deep just aren't right for us? Why would we rather put ourselves through hell than sleep alone at night? Why do we follow leaders who never lead? Why does it take catastrophe to start a revolution if we're so free? Tell me why, someone tell me why. Which do you prefer? Ask the birds. Fear or love, baby, don't say the answer. Actions speak louder than words. Actions speak louder than loud.
Actions speak louder.
Actions speak louder than words.
That was fun. I don't think we actually fully rehearsed the whole song on that one either. Maybe just little parts of it.
It feels like it's a really like kind of a letter rip.
Yeah, yeah, we're just
song. It's like this is what it is. Yeah. Which kind of feels like what you have to be brought to get to that point of like, oh, okay, like, oh boy, I actually am willing. Like, and then it all just comes out, however it comes out, you know?
Yeah, has to hit that pain tolerance for all of us. Like we have to hit that point where we fall to our knees and say, there must be a better way.
Has to be, yeah. Well, with that in mind, maybe the best way to follow that up is fall on me.
Okay. When he first told me he wanted to do this song, I thought, oh, he's crazy. this song has Italian in it. It's an Andrea Bocelli song that he and his son Matteo. I watched their YouTube video and I thought, oh man, that's gonna be a stretch. But we're just letting it all go.
I feel like the first time I heard this song, I really felt something for it. I remember I listened to the song and I felt like this beautiful inspiration to do like video editing. I want to like take that. I think it was a music video at the time, and like I want to take that music video and like rearrange it and do stuff, like share it with people and share the message. And I think, you know, at the time, it might have just been a little bit of resistance to like the pure message of, no, you don't need to rearrange anything. You don't need to like change stuff in form to be worthy of this. You just need to like stop, actually. Stop and let it all go.
Is that what the lyrics mean for you?
Yeah. That's what it came down to, I think. One thing that David shared this morning that kind of stuck out to me, one of his one-liners was, if you wake up in the morning thinking that you know what your day is going to be like or know how your day is going to be, it's probably going to be a bad day. I think that's what I...
Right, you got your to-do list all planned out.
Took from it anyway.
Right.
But it's like, oh, wow, like really taking it that deep feels like a miracle would be needed for me to take it that deep, but that's what I'm here for. Like the experience of that miracle to like really be so clueless actually. But then I think the other side of it, and we were talking a little bit about this earlier, is like there's like a part of that cluelessness that's like completely and utterly open. So it's not like a cluelessness that doesn't include things. Like, oh, I don't wanna put my mind into that because it feels too difficult in the moment. It's like just letting everything pass through or something.
Yeah, it's open to everything. It's clueless about what will happen, what it will do, but it's open. It's like totally open to whatever comes.
Even if it's Italian.
Even if it's Italian.
Yeah.
here's some Italian. It's kind of operatic, even. Like, I always associate Italian with opera, but maybe. This one's in, I do need a capo for this, right? I think it's in F sharp for you, right?
I wasn't going to play it in F sharp.
Oh, okay, right. Good thing I asked. So we're in F.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I think I'll sing the first verse, right?
Let's do that.
Okay, we'll try it. Here we go. I thought sooner or later the lights up above will come down in circles and guide me to love. I don't know what's right for me. I cannot see straight. I've been here too long and I don't want to wait for truth. Fire like a cannonball straight to my soul. Tear me to pieces. Remind me I'm whole. I'm willing to die for it. Carry this weight, but with every step I keep questioning what is true. Fall on me with open arms. Fall on me from where you are. Fall all your life, with all
presto una luce ti illuminerà, seguirà sempre, guidarti saprà. Tu non arrenderti, attento a non perderti, il tuo passato avrà senso per te. Vorrei che credessi in te stesso, ma sì, in ogni passo c'è morai qui. Un viaggio infinito, sorriderò se nel tempo c'è fugge nipote con te. Follow me, ascoltami. Follow me, abbracciami.
That's great.
Thank you.
I remember I struggled with it so much the first time we tried to play it. I thought, oh man, this is going to take a miracle. And we got it. We got a miracle. Wow.
It's interesting. I think part of what helps my ability to just stay connected in the moment is to not do complicated stuff just to do complicated stuff. Right. Like, just because I can do something doesn't mean I should.
Yeah.
I mean that, but also just in terms of like, I don't know, like even with our practice, like getting ready for this session, it's like even tuning in moment to moment, like what is the simplest thing that I can that wants to come through. Actually, like what's the simplest thing that wants to come through, because the spirit's not complicated. So if I'm like trying to reach a note or something, like fall on me, like maybe I just pop it down an octave. Uh-huh. Maybe that's what wants to come through. Because then
pop that baby down an octave.
Because then I can go back to like, okay, what's like, it's a felt experience of expansion then. Like my mind can actually take more in than if I'm like, not zooming in on this one thing out of everything and saying like, oh, that's hard. I need to like put all my effort into it, but then I'm not actually connected with you because all my attention is going toward that one note or
trying
that
to be
one
like a
thing.
Overachiever or something.
Exactly. I can see that a little bit in the, I actually help out in the studio as well when I'm not, you know, presenting. And it comes to me as well there where we have like these like long lists of things and like checklists and things that we make for our sessions, not because we couldn't take it if we didn't have the list, but because without the list, we need to put so much energy into these things that are really quite simple, but then we don't actually have space to consider like, okay, how's it all feeling? Like, is there something else that I need to be considering, or like more taking the bigger picture or just tuning in? So that kind of feels like a little bit similar. Like we just kind of take care of the things that we need to take care of in however it is, lists or just pop it down an octave or whatever it is.
Yeah, just do what's simple. Just, yeah, whatever's easy. And like the spirit's never asking us to be some hero and achieve something great. Yeah, it's the opposite. It's like, no, you don't have any, there's no need to be great. Like God is already, great.
It's good. It's called hero of the dream, not,
right.
not hero in reality. So got it.
Yeah. Exactly. Well, do you have any songs coming to you?
I feel like Back to Love could be nice.
Yeah, that's so beautiful. This one's another Course in Miracles musician. Some of you may know of Donna Marie Carey. Who David actually traveled with her, I think in the 90s. She was writing songs based on the chorus and had a really amazing country voice. But yeah, this one is a song of hers that I learned years ago. It was, yeah, the one that stuck out to me the most, because it's really about letting go of judgment about others, and like it's about holy relationship and giving, like the song's called Back to Love, like I give you back to love. I'm not going to hold you in prison with my ideas about you and what I think, who I think you are. That's the goal, like letting everybody free, letting everybody off the hook of our expectations. So I think so I'll start on guitar. You'll come in on this one, I think.
Yeah.
Oh,
sounds good.
Put it up there for you. By the way, I think Andy's putting these lyrics for these songs into the Zoom chat. So if any of you want to like sing along, you can just click on the chat box and see the lyrics for any of these songs, and maybe that'll help you take
join
them
us.
In. Yeah, join us. We won't hear you, but we'll feel the love.
My idea of what I think you are cannot compare to what you really are. You're much more than I could ever dream you to be. I can't lock your image in time. Try to change you or make you mine. I'll give you to love what you were meant to be. And now the greatest gift that I can give is to give you back to love. Back to what you were meant to be. When I give you to love, I give love to me. Give you back to love.
Yeah, I love that song. Really love that song. Great lyrics. Donna Marie Carey, if you want to hear some beautiful Course in Miracles songs, look her up on Google. And she has an album called Real Love, which I've listened to many times. I think she wrote it while she was traveling with David, actually, and the Spirit was just pouring through her. And yeah, just incredible songs. How's it going?
Feel pretty blank. I don't know what's going on.
Yeah. That's the goal. Tabula rasa.
Maybe it's okay.
Going into the emptiness.
Yeah.
Blank slate. Well, I feel like I could do maybe one more of my originals. I'm not sure which one, but
I was thinking maybe forgiveness.
I don't know. That's a that requires a lot of energy. I feel more laid back, actually. I'm open, though. Maybe let's just see if there's...
What else do we got?
Any other ones? Yeah. We made a list of like 20 songs for this concert, so we'd have lots of material.
I think Shine Through feels pretty sparkly.
Nice. Yeah.
Just kind of...
I feel like that song's a little more on par with my vibe at the moment.
My message, my just relax message as well.
Yeah, okay. Yeah. Put the cape on here. Thanks. How are all you feeling? Good. See some thumbs up and some hearts, some love hearts.
Great.
Okay. I don't need the lyrics for this one. I think I should know this
one. Let you take it.
Yeah, we'll see. Sometimes I do forget lyrics to my own songs, though, sometimes. So you might have to...
You can fill in.
Or I'll look over the lyrics there.
Yeah.
One, two, three. Feel free to come in whenever you want. Whisper to me, everything is fine. Now all I wanna do is listen to you. Tell me everything I've got to do to open up and let your love shine through. I can see your face, smile, smile, smile. The time I spend with you is so worthwhile. Now all I want to do is look at you, let your smiling face teach me how to open up and let your love shine.
Shine. I hear your laughter and it heals.
gentle laughter teaching me how to open up and let your love shine.
Thank you. How lovely. One big collaboration, one big holy collaborative relationship here.
Swept up in this whirl.
Yeah. Let's see what else we got on our list here.
I feel like both sides now is actually coming to mind.
Yeah, yeah. Joni Mitchell.
It's a beautiful song. It just kind of, yeah, sort of the side that we've been talking about throughout. I feel like a line from one of our go-to movies is coming to mind, Solaris, where one of the crew members says, I could tell you what's going on, but I don't know if that
wouldn't really
tell you what's going on. And I think this song by Joni Mitchell is kind of related to that in my mind, in that it's like, we have concepts for everything, but it doesn't really tell us like what it actually is, which I think is why this journey of awakening or this path that we're on is like it has to come from within. Like there's no other place to go. So it's like Joni talks about clouds, life, and love, I think.
Yeah. I really don't know clouds at all. I really don't know love at all. And finally, I really don't know life.
Yeah. So she gets like three big ones. But I think we can generalize that to everything. Right?
Yeah. It's a song of humbleness, like the two sides. I've looked at life from both sides now. There's the two sides, and then, yeah, they're both wrong. It's all, yeah.
Yeah, and then just drop both of them. Actually, I feel like in our kind of talking a little bit before the session, some of that came up where it's like you would share, I would share, and then it's like, okay, but neither of those things is actually it. I'm trying to think of a specific, because I feel like it came up multiple times where it's like, yeah, I would share something like, yeah, I feel like a lot of pressure to get it right. So I'm just gonna drop it all and let it go, and moment by moment, tune into the connection. And you would share something like, yeah, when you share that, I feel a little bit nervous that like it's not going to go well, and it's not going to sound good, and you're just going to be off doing your own thing, or something. So I don't want to do that either. But then it's like anything where there are sides actually isn't really it. Like, I looked at life from both sides. I guess we can stop there. Cause...
Yeah, that's a good example. Because, yeah, you said, well, I can't really try to play it perfectly. So I'm just going to, like, I forgot what you said. But I remember when you said that, then it made me feel nervous. Like, well, I don't want you just to, like, go and, like, totally forget about me and go into the ethers or something. And it was like, those were, like, two sides. Like, we both had our perspective, but then after we both expressed, then like it was like the Holy Spirit, then the miracle could kind of dawn on our mind, like the middle way, which is not on one side or the other. And yeah, you're right, that's why expressing private thoughts can be so helpful in a safe space like we have.
Yeah, because it's like as long as there's kind of this constriction in the mind, like this is my box and this is what it has to be. Well, really anything where it's like it's either this or this. I think David sort of shares about that a number of times, like as long as you're giving the Holy Spirit options, like tell me, Holy Spirit, which of these two options is the best. Then it's like, well, not really asking at that point.
Yeah, then you've already got your limited. It's got to be one of these two and nothing outside of that. And
takes willingness, I guess, to open to.
Tabula rasa.
There it is. So,
yeah.
Yeah.
Give it a shot.
Okay. I learned the song like, I don't know, like probably 15 years ago before I was into the chorus. A lot of songs I just remember learning because I felt a resonance with them. And then after I got into the chorus, I was like, wow, now I know why I was so attracted to it. Even before then. Okay. Oh, we've got to pull it up on here too, just in case I need the lyrics. Okay, are we going to start together? Or? What are we doing?
I think so.
Okay, great. That's exciting. I'll give us a little count. One, two, three.
Rose of flows of angel hair, ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons. Looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and snow on everyone. So many things I would have done. Clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down. Still somehow it's cloud illusions. I recall I really don't know clouds at all. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way you feel. Tale comes real. I've looked at love that way. Now it's just another show. You leave them laughing when you go. And if you care, don't let it show. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take. And still somehow it's love's illusions. I recall I really don't know love at all.
movies and circus crowds. Looked at life that way. Now old friends are acting strange. They shake their heads, they say I've changed. Something's lost, but something's gained. Living every day. I've looked at life from both sides now, from win or lose, but still somehow it's life's illusions. I recall, I really don't know life at all.
Yeah, it's always good to sing these songs, and then it's like reminding ourselves, yeah, I really don't know, and all these deep songs that remind us. It's like we need to not just read these ideas, but we need to speak them or sing them to like really feel. That's why, you know, all these songs that came to me, I just had to keep singing them to like, because it kept reinforcing the idea, and we all need to just keep practicing these ideas, like speaking them to others, you know, talking about them, singing them, whatever form it takes to reinforce. Yeah, it takes a lot of reinforcement.
Right. I'm reminded that you really only have two options. It's either extending or projecting in each moment, not even like as like a, oh, that's nice. It's like, in each moment, that's the choice. Like, are you giving or
trying to get?
Trying to get, yeah. That would be the other.
Yeah, it's true.
Alternative.
Forgiving or forgetting. Forgetting God. That's the choices. We can either forgive or we're just clueless in the wrong way. Clueless of the Spirit's love.
Yeah, well, it's interesting. Like that, it's interesting you said like clueless in the wrong way, because I feel like one of those sides that we were discussing would be an example of like cluelessness in the wrong way. Like either just, yeah, it got away from me. I don't know what I was about to say, but yeah.
Now we can be clueless in the right way.
Join you in that.
Okay, do you have any in your mind?
This isn't really something we talked about earlier, but I'm wondering if we want to do like a 10-minute meditation or something.
Oh, music meditation.
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds good. I love doing that. I love just singing too, like making up song words in the moment. And, you know, just whatever feels inspiring. Yeah, maybe we could just pick a key and wing it.
We're talking about the practical application, so yeah, let's like all join in that, and then maybe there's a song or two.
Yeah.
To finish it up after.
That sounds great. I love doing that. Yeah.
Sweet. How about?
I'll just follow you. Maybe you can tell me what key you're in. Let's see.
F.
Okay.
Let's go F.
All right. Probably the hardest key for me. I'll just capo up so it's easy.
No, it'll be great. Easy. There's the Spirit solution right there.
There we go.
'Cause I don't know. Wanna open my heart to all the things in my soul. Carry me home.
have this Kim Walker song in my mind, the I Surrender. I don't know if you have it over there. But... Some of you have heard me talk about like how I used to hate worship songs, like Christian worship songs. And I don't know, like, it's like over the years of getting into the course and starting to hear these songs with the Spirit's interpretation. I don't know, they just move me. This one woman in particular, Kim Walker, you might have heard her on YouTube. She's in the band Jesus Culture. And man, she's just got so much passion. What's that song? I don't know if you've heard that. It was the first one I heard from her where she sings, he is jealous for me. And I remember when I first heard that, like, what? That God's not jealous. And I hate all these Christian lyrics. But then I started to hear it as like love, like he wants my full attention, because he knows that's the only thing that will bring me joy. And this is another one of her songs that always touched me, called I Surrender. It looks like I might have it in a different key here. E flat, or maybe yeah. That's good, okay. Yeah. It's like a love song to God.
Surrender everything. love makes it worth it. Your love makes it worth it all. Your love makes it worth it all. Your love makes it worth it. Your love makes it worth it. Your love makes it worth it all. All to you I surrender everything, every part. My dreams, all of me, all to you, I surrender everything, every part of me, all to you, I surrender all of my dreams, all of trust you, God, oh, I surrender. To you, God, oh, I surrender.
I think we're at maybe one last song, maybe.
Yeah.
Looks like we're right near the...
approaching the top of the hour. But yeah, thanks everyone for being here with us and joining us as we kind of explore what music is. I still don't know what it is, yeah, but
I really don't know what music is.
A little
is.
Bit more sure
we'll
now.
And we should make a new verse to that song. Fourth verse about music.
Yeah, that's great.
That's really it. It's like I was even sharing with Zach earlier that I like all these judgments will come up about, oh, it doesn't, we need to make it sound right and it has to sound good. And the whole thing comes from thinking that I actually know what music should sound like and thinking I know what music is, and doesn't bring any peace to hold on to that.
Yeah, it can be surprising how deep it goes. Like, I remember in the Laws of Chaos.
The section in the chorus?
Yeah, it's a section in the chorus where Jesus says, you may think you don't believe these laws, but if you wake
believe
up
you're
and
on solid ground, then you do.
See you're, yeah, on solid ground, then you do believe him. And it's kind of like I'm feeling this way with the knowing what things are. Like, you may believe you know something, but...
Yeah.
There's not even a qualification there, brother, you don't.
yeah, you just absolutely... Jesus isn't mincing words. Making it very direct. You don't know anything. And once you accept that, you'll finally be happy. So what do you think? Do you have any thoughts of a... I feel like I want to do one of my originals, but I don't know. Maybe forgiveness, like you mentioned earlier, but what other ones are left?
Disguise.
Right.
I think I like forgiveness the best.
Yeah, that sounds good.
Yeah. Okay, great.
We'll close with forgiveness. Good place to
open, close, and everything in between.
Yeah,
it's a nice bow tie.
Wrap it up with the theme, the deepest theme. I don't think we've played this one before together. Or maybe we rehearsed a little bit.
We rehearsed it, sort of.
Sort of, yeah. Okay. This one's kind of a rocker, too, so we're going to end on a high energy note to send everyone off to sleep. Okay, here we go. Are you starting at the beginning?
No.
Okay.
It is time to finally see I am not who I've believed myself to be. I must be determined to see beyond this world that was made to blind me by hiding the key that could open up the door of my heart where I know you really are. I can't believe I've been searching for so long outside for what was already mine. You told me over and over that I was your son, but I couldn't hear it. Finally I took a chance and I gave you my life.
Over and over that I was the one, but I couldn't hear it finally. I took a chance and I gave you my life, and you gave me. I can't believe I've been searching for so long outside for what was already mine. You told me over and over that I was your son, and you gave me forgiveness. You gave me forgiveness.
Wow. Yeah, that was, I don't know, I just, that was a miraculous experience for me. I definitely, yeah, after we rehearsed yesterday, I remember going home thinking, oh man, we just weren't gelling at all, and that's, it's going to be horrible. And all these people have paid good money. All these thoughts, like, we better do a good show. Yeah, but all that stuff. After I heard David's talk this morning, actually, I felt like something inside of me just relaxed so deeply. Mm. Like, it really reminded me that it's all about just peace in this moment and nothing else. And yeah, it's been beautiful to collaborate with you.
Yeah, thank you, Erik. I really appreciate the transparency. And... Mm.
Yeah. Yeah.
Thank you all.
Yeah.
Being here with us.
Yeah. Yeah, thank you guys so much. It's a joy to be with you. I see the hearts coming up. Thanks for the hearts. Yeah. And I'm excited. We've got quite a movie. David's picked out a movie I haven't seen in years, but I remember it was like, wow, it was really fun and exciting and deep. So,
yeah, stay tuned for the next.
Yeah.
Cracking open with a movie.
Yeah.
It's going to be good.
Yeah.
So rest well, everyone, and I'll be cheering you on from the from behind a computer. Tomorrow.
He'll be back in the studio.
Yeah.
Behind the control booth. Yeah. Love you guys. Love you so much.
Much love.
Bye. Thank you.
Okay. Well, thank you, Zach and Andy. Yeah, that was beautiful. What a beautiful session. Thanks, everyone. Yeah, so join us tomorrow morning at 9 a.m. MDT. We've got our movie day with David and myself and all of you, and we're going to be joined by our movie workshop participants too. So it's going to be a beautiful day, so looking forward to it. So rest well, and we'll see you tomorrow. Bye for now.